Noise at 6 o'clock in the morning in Surbiton.
They do.
Who do?
We do.
Well, I call it damned inconsiderate. I'd agree with you if it wasn't necessary, but it is. It's Mother Nature, isn't it? At this time of year, she says, dig my earth, she says, plant my crop, she says. It's no good having a go at me. Take it up with her. I'll take it up with someone if this goes on, I'm telling you.
Jerry.
No, I mean it. Oh, damn it all. I've got to get up and go to work in a couple of hours' time.
Well, then you'd better go back to Ben's at the morning with us, hadn't you?
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh,
here you are.
Stop. Ready?
This, that's it.
Think, madam, please. When I took the job as au pair here, I didn't think this sort of thing would go on.
I'm just thinking how lucky I am.
Really?
I mean, I've got you at home all day, haven't I?
Yes. Yes, you are pretty lucky, yes. Of course, you know, a lot of wives would get irritated with their husbands hanging around all day, but well... Oh, yeah, I suppose it depends on the quality of the man, really.
Oh, I'm not saying you don't irritate me. I'm just saying it's nice having you at home.
It's really filthy, this cup you're supposed to wash up, you know. Now we are lucky, though.
Yes.
Well, take this afternoon. I could be cooped up in some rotten little office. You could be playing bumper cars to Moosack in the supermarket. Instead, we'll be out there putting our own sweet potatoes in our own ground. It makes you think, doesn't it?
Yes, tell you what it makes me think.
What's that, love?
Why can't you work in an office like a normal man?
Oh.
Well, it is a rotten job planting 15 rows of potatoes. In anybody's book, it's back-breaking.
Ah, was, I would have said.
What do you mean?
Planting potatoes was back-breaking until the invention of... the non-stoop goodoscope.
Oh, what in heaven's name is that?
The result of all that banging in the cellar yesterday.
And the bad language.
And the bad language.
What does it do?
Bung some potatoes in there, would you? Go on. Come with it. What does it do? Put them in there. Go on, put them all in there, right down there. That's it, one at a time. All right, now, hold it. Now, come over here, will you? Come over here. All right, now. There's your run, right? Down
yes.
There, up and down, right? All right, now, watch carefully. You watching? One potato. 12 inches between. Second potato. Third potato. Fourth potato, so on. What do you think of that?
I think that's very clever.
And you notice I didn't have to bend down once?
Of course, they're not all eyes upwards, are they?
Are they?
No. If they're not all eyes upwards, they won't grow properly, will they?
I know that.
Well?
Well, it's perfectly simple, isn't it? All you do is follow behind me and turn the right way up.
Which means bending down?
Well, yes.
Which is what you were trying to avoid in the first place.
It is also a musical instrument.
You're a bit clever, play it.
It's also a wife beater.
I didn't knock, because good manners seem to be a thing of the past in this house. I will simply ask you to return my nutcrackers.
What nutcrackers?
The nutcrackers you borrowed in 1967. And so conveniently forgot to return.
Oh, yeah. I'm so sorry, Margot.
How time flies, eh?
Are these the ones?
Thank you.
They don't crack Brazils.
They did when I had the use of them. Excuse me.
Is that all you came for?
All. Barbara, if you cannot see that my asking for the return of my nutcrackers is symbolic of a shattered relationship, then I'm sorry for you.
Ah, you mean this morning?
Yes, I do. And so far as I'm concerned, there is nothing more to be said on the matter.
I'd like to say something.
There is nothing you can say, Tom.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't.
Yes, there is. We're sorry.
What are you implying?
Nothing. We're apologizing. We talked about it when we came in and realized that we were in the wrong. It's as simple as that.
Oh.
Sorry.
Oh.
Yes, we will try and be as quiet as mice until a reasonable time in the morning.
Oh.
And I won't start the rotary cultivator until you're up.
Oh. Do you have any nutcrackers of your own?
Do we have any nutcrackers of our own?
No, we don't.
No, we don't.
Thank you, Margot.
And they do work with Brazils.
Would one have bought them, had they not?
One would not, Margot. One would not.
I'm glad we're friends again.
So am I. You can help us put our potatoes in now.
Well, I'm not that sort of friend.
I think we ought to frame these. I mean, after all, they are a symbol of peace between our two great nations.
Yeah, well, this great nation better get cracking with its agricultural policy first.
Ah, yes, I suppose. I'm just trying to put it off.
Gotta be done, love.
I know that.
Never mind, my brain and your brawn.
Your brain?
Get out of the garden!
I can't get my willies off.
Can't you?
No. Barbara, I can't get my willies off.
All right, come on.
No, no, I'm too tired.
Good.
Well, we got the potatoes in.
I've gone off potatoes.
All we're going to do now is reduce the rest of the garden to a fine tilt, do the sale of the allotments, get the early seeds under clutches, all the onions sets in, build the extension of the pigsty with Pinky's litter, and we're all set up for another year.
Is that all?
Apart from the routine chores, yeah.
Hysterical laughter. It wasn't as hard as this last year, was it?
Probably. I can't remember. I think I've got amnesia.
Do you know who I hate more than anyone else at this moment?
Me?
No, even worse than you.
Who then?
That Mother Nature woman. She has a holiday all winter, then comes back and bang, wallop goes raving mad.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, you see, it could be that we're approaching this the wrong way.
If those potatoes have to come up, I shall set light to your hair.
No. I'm talking about nature's clock. I mean, now look, have you ever seen a sparrow yawning?
No.
And why?
They probably hold their wings in front of their beaks when they do it, I don't know.
Because they follow nature's clock. They get up with the sun and they go to bed with the sun.
Clever dicks.
What I'm saying is, Barbara, why don't we do the same?
But it's only 7 o'clock. Nobody goes to bed at 7 o'clock.
Ah, but it's only 7 o'clock because your watch says so.
Well, I'm funny like that. I usually tell the time by looking at my watch.
But it's not important. What I'm saying is, why don't we try working while it's light and going to bed when it's dark?
Well, we'd never see anybody.
Well, only for a bit, only while we've got this heavy workload on. I know it seems a bit odd, but, well, it's common sense, love.
All right. I'm game if you are. I am whacked.
Right. Oh.
Of course, you know, if Margot comes in now and finds we've gone to bed, you know what she's going to think, don't you?
Well, I mean, sir, it's not out of the question, is it?
The way we feel.
Yes, you're quite right. No, come on, it's freezing in here.
I can't get my wellies off now.
I can't get sleep in them.
I've heard about men like you.
Oh, all right. Oh, blimey, you've still got your trousers on as well.
Well, I would have, wouldn't I?
What?
Oh, here, here.
Get off the plank, get off the plank. Oh. Good. Oh. Come on, it's freezing. Oh.
Oh, that's better.
Yeah, I told you it would be.
Do you realise the arches are still on?
Now, look, don't keep thinking about the time. We're just two little animals doing the most natural thing in the world. We're allowing ourselves to drift into unconsciousness so our bodies can recharge until the sun wakes up tomorrow. It's beautifully simple, you see.
Yes, put like that, yes it is.
Good night, love.
Night.
Last one. I don't feel sleepy now.
Neither do I.
Still, give it a chance, give it a chance.
Do you remember when Grace Archer died in that fire?
Barbara.
Sorry.
Some people actually sent wreaths, you know.
Well, you wouldn't expect them to send get well cards, would you? Do you remember when Walter Gabriel...
Now, look, Barbara, we are here to try and get some sleep, not discuss the Archers.
Sorry.
All right.
You were the one who brought up people sending wreaths.
Only because you brought up Grace Archer. Let's drop the subject, please.
All right.
Thank you. Oh. Oh.
You're going to start your puffing. I'm going to start talking about Walter Gabriel again.
I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was doing it.
Well, you were.
Well, I'm sorry.
All right.
All right, then. What?
I can't hear you breathing.
I was trying to breathe quietly so as not to keep you awake.
Breathe normally, then.
Okay. Oh.
Now you're puffing.
Goodness sake! If I can put up with your twitching, surely you can put up with a bit of puffing.
What do you mean, twitching?
You were twitching.
I don't twitch, I don't twitch, Tom.
You're like a puppy having a bad dream, you are.
Oh, this is unnatural.
How about you haven't given it a fair chance?
Well, I mean, it's ridiculous going to bed at this time of day when we go to bed. Normally we just lie down, go to sleep, and don't have a row about who's twitching and who's puffing.
I'm sorry, love, but you've just given in to the obvious. The fact is that you are tired. It's only habit that's keeping you awake.
Right, what's keeping you awake, then?
You are.
You lying hound.
It's true, it's absolutely true. If I was here on my own, I'd just close my eyes and be away in no time.
Oh, all right, then, go on, get on with it.
I will. Right. Oh. My move, cheat. Morning. Tired, love.
Tired? Why should I be tired? Went to bed with the sun, got up with the sun. In fact, I had no sleep between going to bed and getting up. It's neither here nor there. Why should I be tired?
No, no, it wasn't a total success, was it?
I don't think so. I think I realised that after about the fifth game of chess.
What time was that?
12.
When did we finish listing our top 20 films?
About 1:30.
Yeah, I'm still not sure about Psycho, you know.
Oh, well, never mind. Another night like that, you'll be living with one.
I'll tell you something very interesting, though. Very interesting indeed. We couldn't even get to sleep at our normal time, could we?
Now, that is fantastically interesting. That is.
It is, it is. I'll tell you one thing. There's more to metabolism than meets the eye.
If you don't shut up, my fist will meet your eye.
Hey, hey! There's no point in getting annoyed with me.
Well, I'm overtired, and I get annoyed with who I like when I am overtired, and I am overtired.
Sorry, love.
Not your fault. Good idea, just didn't work, that's all.
I'll tell you what.
What?
You go back to bed and sleep as long as you like. I'll get on with all the work, and you can join me when and if you want to. How about that?
Oh, Tom.
Didn't
it? Oh. Come on then, let's get at it.
All right, all right. Come on, buddy, come on. Here we go. That's better. Oh. What?
We promised not to wake Margo and Jerry, remember?
Oh, yes.
What are you doing?
I'm silencing the bucket for when I milk the goat.
Hello, Pinky. How's my little mother to be?
Hey, Barbara, I think there's something wrong with the goat.
Why?
Well, it's a milk. Look, it's got blue streaks in it.
Did you leave that sponge in there?
Yeah.
Well, the last thing I did was to mop up some paraffin with it.
Oh! I know what I have. It's ever so hard being considerate, isn't it?
Yes, that's because it's foreign to your nature. Look, I'm going to go and get the eggs. You chop some wood for the rain.
How do I chop wood without making a noise?
Use a rubber axe.
Morning, peasants.
Jerry!
Well, I'm certainly not the fairy at the bottom of your garden.
But you're up. You're dressed.
You're remarkably perceptive this morning.
Well, let's get one thing absolutely clear. We did not wake you up.
No, Margot did.
We didn't wake her up either.
No, no.
Then why are you out here moaning at us?
I just said good morning.
Because we have been totally silent. Unless, of course, you can't breathe in.
Yes, and totally considered. You can't claim to have heard a single noise from us this morning.
I don't.
And why? Why? Because we have greatness of spirit, that's why.
It could also have something to do with the fact that we weren't here.
What?
We stayed overnight with some friends at Chobham. We've only just got back.
Well, you might have told us, you thoughtless swine. Come on, hurry up, I'll go on the bed.
Well, it's 8 o'clock, isn't it?
Yes.
Going to bed, aren't we?
Yes.
Well, there we are, just a few things to keep us going those 6 or 7 hours before we go to sleep. There's chess and Halma, that word game that we never understand the rules of, and Tiddlywinks and Snakes and Ladders, and a pen and paper to write down our 50 favourite songs. Oh, and a snack in case we get hungry.
So you're not overconfident of getting to sleep, then?
Did I give you that impression?
Well, sort of.
Oh, I do try, Tom, honestly. It's just I'm not convinced that adjusting to nature's clock is all that simple.
But where Waxwick came in from that garden dead beat, I mean, you actually fell asleep digging once, and that's not easy to do.
But you can't just go to sleep at 8 o'clock in the evening.
Look, I understand how you feel, love, but won't you just... Look, just try and snuggle down and... Well, just try and let go, eh, love? Eh, love?
Oh.
Who?
Hello.
Probably. It's people in the road. Go to sleep.
Lousy devils.
It's all right. They're gone now. Go to sleep.
Stop!
I'll kill them.
What is it? Drunks?
No, it's not drunks. It's those so-called friends of ours next door. They're having a party.
Oh, not tonight, not tonight.
Shut up! So much for consideration.
Oh, it's not fair. I mean, after all, what is gander for the sausage, goose for the other?
Exactly. I mean, we do all we could when they complained, and what do we get in return? Des O'Connor in the middle of the night. Will you shut up? Oh! Right, that is it!
Where are you going?
I'm going round there to break it up. That's where I'm going.
Wait for me. I'm in the mood for a bit of violence myself.
You can shut up for a start. Don't bother getting out of the car. The party is over.
A cloth, please, Jerry. Antonio's been careless with her coleslaw. Tom, Bob, Stephanie, Denzel, do come in.
Right, well, give them one drink. That's all they'll be getting.
Oh, really?
Now, don't get on your high horse with me, Margot.
Hello.
Consideration works both ways, you know.
It's lovely to see you. Do go in. Everybody, Stephanie and Denzel. It's lovely to see you. Now, you please tell me what on earth you're talking about.
Silent gardening, that's what we're talking about. We promised not to make a row when you're in bed in the morning, so what do we get in return? Bedlam. I mean, just what time of night do you call this, Margot?
It's 8:30.
Exactly. I think it's pretty poor. What?
I said it's 8:30.
Oh.
At night?
Of course. We've only been asleep for half an hour.
Bless you, darling. Good Lord. It's the wee willy winkies.
Hello, Jerry.
Hello, Jerry.
What are you wearing your pyjamas for?
You came round to complain, Jerry. About us.
Yes, but why put your pyjamas on today?
We were in bed.
8:30 at night? Why?
Jerry! No, we were... We were just tired out, that's all.
I see. Come to think of it, you did look pretty awful this morning.
Well, I mean, we've got a right to look awful. I mean, after all, you know, it gets a bit frantic for us at this time of year.
Well, come on, join the party. A couple of gallons of booze for as good as 10 hours sleep.
Shall we?
Why not? We're fit, we're healthy. Who needs sleep?
Good, come on, then.
Tom, Barbara, aren't you going to change first?
Into what? These are our best clothes.
No, promise to tell everyone that you thought it was a pyjama party.
Only if you slip into yours, Margot.